Yo, okay, hello guys, it's Legat here, and today we are here for the APA Academy Week 8 battle against Shy Guy, the coach of the San Diego Fellas, who took our victory in the APA Indigo with that Ice Beam Freeze on our Yuxi, and I'm here to get my revenge. So, you can see the team over there and the, my team over there, but first off, go check all the APA coaches out and record of my Battle Lantern show being the goat of the season with the Gohanks recording our games like champs. Gotta appreciate those dudes doing the God's work. But going to my team, we have our Sylveon as our first man. Why do we have that Sylveon? Let's talk about their team first, because I'm going off the rails. So they do have the Yveltal, which is probably top 2 man in the format. Some say top 1, some say top 2, and some say top 3. Up there, really, really annoying to deal with. Really good man. And then they have Excadrill and Gigalith, so they do have that Sanko. Mega Alakazam is always scary for the speed tier, because they can run any fucking set they want, and they outspeed everything. And then Kyurem, Terrakion, Aromatisse, Lantern, Talonflame, Yuxi, Suicune. Suicune is a funny thing because I didn't know they had Suicune before I saw it in the team. I thought they had Feraligatr. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. I don't have anything in my team to kill that Suicune if they do get the Charmander. So yeah. So what I think they are going to bring, Terrakion is must come. Yveltal is a must come. I think Kyurem is really good against us. And then the water type, be it Feraligatr or Suicune, is really good. And then stuff like Mega Sam is really scary. Gigalith Excadrill Core might come. And Yuxi is pretty good as well. Kinda. It doesn't like our Ubers at all, but no. But yeah, I think Lantern ain't coming. Gogot ain't coming because we don't have a lot it wants to try to wall. And I don't think Talonflame is coming. So those three are not coming in my opinion. And our then let's go into my team. We have Sylveon to counter the Yveltal. And while building I optimize these sets truly. I'm trying to take care of special attacking Yveltal, as well as the physical attacking Yveltal. So, because Sylveon can take the special one just fine. Like, just fine, no problems. It can take 3 hits easily from Dark Pulse and Oblivion Wing. Depending on, of course, their set, but if they are Life Orb, we can protect some HP with our leftovers back. But physical with acrobatics and like Roselibery, because Sylveon is my most obvious answer to this Yveltal, that can be really annoying. Or then they can be like Citrus Berry, that would work as well, because our Hyper Voice does put them below 50%. So something like that could be something they bring. So we have to be scared about those, because we can take one acrobatics easily with this defense and HP, like no problem. But 2 we can take if they are acrobatics and max attack. AV set could be coming on Yveltal, or then just general life orb special attacking set that hurts my whole team. But yeah, we do have the type of voice, Wish and Protect, and Toxic on this mod. Hyper Voice obvious Yveltal, and Toxic is there if they do want to switch into something like Aromatisse or something like that. Gigalith might be a good dual this thing as well. But Excadrill is obviously most most relevant answer to the Sylveon, and we don't have a lot for that, but anyways. And yeah, the speed EV is doing nothing there, like it doesn't do anything. It's just over EVs that went over, and then we have max HP, and I believe the special attack is to Tuoko, Yveltal, if they are AV up to rocks or something like that. But yeah, special defense is there to not get three solid and most of the time, and defense is there just because. And then we go into our Giratina, which will always lure in the Yveltal pretty much. And we have Willowish for that, so if they are physical, we can manage that after we get the Willowish buff. And then this is our wall to stuff like Excadrill with the Earthquake, Terrakion. Terrakion is really scary because if they do get the plus 2 Swords Dance up and they have Rockimsy, this man is gone. This man is completely gone, even with these defenses and HPs. Like, this man goes, like, it dies to the Rockimsy a plus 2, so yeah. That's scary, but Willowwisp is there to cripple those physical attackers down. And this man is good to take care of Yuxi as well, sometimes. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's just there. And this, like, this brings you Yveltal in always. It's a free switch into this if it's not physical. And yeah. But if it's not physical, we do have that free switch into Sylveon. And even if it's physical, we have that Will-O-Wisp, so we can take care of that. And yeah, these EVs are pretty much, we have enough attack, I believe we are, this is best chance to 1-0 go Terrakion, I believe, after rocks. Or something like that. And then Max Polkon defense, just pretty much. And 4 special attack, because that was only EV that really mattered on the damage that Shadow Ball does. Like 28 on special attack really didn't do anything. Then we go into our Exada from Osa with that expert belt and max speed, max attack, so we do always outspeed that Mega Alakazam and U-turn poison jab, low kick and high jump kick. So, high jump kick always 1-0 goes. Excadrill, Kyurem, Terrakion, it does insane amount of damage to Yveltal. Even Yuxi doesn't take it that well, and if it comes in on this high jump kick, U-turn is always there. Aromatis doesn't want high jump kick and poison jab from this. Well, Suicune, I didn't really count on it, but Suicune can take that, I think, somewhat well. But yeah, like, high jump kick does a lot to every single man on that team with this coverage, so that's cool. And low kick, I believe, Oko, Sex, Excadrill, and Terrakion as well, so those are, like, safe bets. I'm not sure, low kick didn't Oko, Excadrill, I believe, something like that. Then we have our Aerodactyl with the Rockimsy get that Yveltal with the Revenge skill option if they are physical or something on now. Sylveon. And then it obviously can take care of the Talonflame. This can bust out the Feraligatr if they have that. But this can do some damage to Suicune as well. And this is really good option to revenge kill the Terrakion as well. And we have Taunt exactly for Terrakion if we don't want that thing doing anything. Yeah. Or if they do switch in Yuxi or something, if they show that it's there switching, then we just taunt them. So yeah. And Suicune can be taunted as well if we don't want them to rest and call them up on us. So speed is enough for, let's see. I believe it's for Terrakion. Yeah, Terrakion, I believe this is for. And almost max attack and just leftover EVs on those defensive stats. Then we have our Shin 3 Mega Aggron with the Heavy Slam, Earthquake, Steadrock and Toxic. Steadrocks are really good in this matchup because Yveltal is a thing. And Toxic is really good for stuff like Suicune, Feraligatr that would be coming in, or Gigalith that comes in, or Excadrill. I believe Excadrill will be Moldbreaker this game because of Aggron. So yeah. And then Heavy Slam and Earthquake pretty much hit enough on their team to not be scared of anything else. So we don't need any other covers. We have 12 on attack and we have enough defense for something. I don't remember what this was for. But max HP and almost max special defense as well. I think this was like for Choice Panda Terrakion or something. Maybe. But yet then we come into a win condition. The Digespi with the focus as huge power. Return Earthquake, Agility and Swords Dance. This can set up on stuff like Excadrill because it scares it out completely. This can set up on Uxie. This can set up on Gigalith. This can set up on Aromatese as well. And yeah, this can set up pretty damn easily in this matchup, depending on their ancestors stuff. So yeah, we have enough speed, so we do outspeed Yveltal and stuff like Mega Sam after Agility. But Scarf Yveltal will be outspeeding us. And we have to be scared of the Sucker Punch Yveltal and Quick Attack Terrakion. So yeah, and Aqua Jet Feraligatr that isn't even a thing, so yeah. We have max attack, E, and defense and special defense and HP, just rest on those. But yeah, that's the team, and we will see you guys soon in the match. Here we are with the match, and they are indeed bringing Yveltal, Excadrill and Kyurem, and then the Aromatese, Terrakion and Suicune. And here I was like, oh my lord, they have Suicune, what the heck did I miss? And I went to check on the dock we have, and goddamn. Suicune was just there, and I didn't prep for that, so yeah, that's a scary, scary situation to be in, but yeah. But this seems like a really good matchup for Digespi, obviously, because this Digespi scares off stuff like Terrakion, it scares off Excadrill, and those pretty much be really, really those side. And I'm leading with Mega Akron if they do decide to lead with stuff like Excadrill and Terrakion, and the worst lead would be Suicune, and the Suicune indeed was the lead. So yeah, that's a shame, and I'm indeed Mega Evolving, and I believe we do that Toxic on that. Right, do we Toxic or did we stand on? Which we did. We are eating Scald turn 1, and we take 46 damage and get burned, which ain't really a surprise here, and we do indeed Toxic on them, so that's... I think that's a fine trade for us, because I don't have anything for this Suicune. So if they are not rest, we are Gucci, because this can wall us completely. So that's nice. Do we go for this Elf or not? Did I? Yeah, I swapped out because we can still take a hit from, I believe, Terrakion. And we need this for Aromatese as well, if something doesn't go right. We go into our Sylveon, because Sylveon can take this card best, and if we get burnt, that would be the best. But we didn't. So if they do have that Toxic, we are going to get Toxic here. So that's the same. But I'm here just racking up poison damage, and I'm going to see how they... what is the option for the Sylveon, and they do carry the Toxic. And if they would have swapped into Excadrill, we would have be able to drop into a Giratina there. And now we go for the twist, because we do want that Mega Akron healthy. And we want those rocks up as well. I believe we just hard swap into Mega Akron, eating the Scald and then healing up with the Wish. So yeah, and the Toxic damage would be insanely high next turn, so they would be forced to switch out into Excadrill. But they indeed go into the Excadrill right here, I believe. Yeah, they go straight into Excadrill, and I'm going to go into the Mega Akron. And let's heal ourselves back up. We need that help. And here I properly hard swap into Giratina right here. Because we are burned, I don't want to take the Moldbreaker Earthquake and not get any damage on it with the Earthquake. And yeah, we go into our Giratina here. And this is free below, which nothing is immune to it. And half the team doesn't like it. So yeah. Well, Suicune is immune to it, but I don't care if it comes in. And we do take 66 damage from that Earthquake, so that does quite a lot. So 51 of the leftovers, so we can take like 3 more of those. And Earthquake really hurts it. And I went for the Willows because Excadrill wouldn't be able to do anything anymore if we do get that burn. No, we didn't go for the Willows. I think I read this Yveltal coming in, and I went into my Aerodactyl to get that offensive pressure on it, which is fine. And I believe I went for the Stone Edge here, and not the Joachim C, because the swap is obvious, and I thought that maybe Ezreal would be coming in. So I go for the Stone Edge, and somehow I think that they wouldn't stay in here because they don't know my item. Because Joachim C would kill this Suicune on this place, so I would think they would go in Ezreal. If it's so, they would eat that Stone Edge up, and I Earthquake, so even if it comes, we do get that huge damage on them, but they did stay in and scald on us and does like damn 100 damage and get another burn, so that's that. And now we have to burn our Rock MC because now they don't accept us getting that Rock MC because we didn't show it to them. But yeah, we do have the Rock MC. Aerodactyl is getting a kill on this Suicune, which is nice, because Suicune was some art that we couldn't kill at any point of the game, because it's scary. So yeah, I'm happy that we do get it right here, right now with the Continental Crush. Aerodactyl going in, dropping that rock on them. A seismic slab or something. And yep. We do take the burn damage here. And what do they go? They go to Ezreal. I'm just staying in to see if they are scarfed or something and go for the Earthquake because Aerodactyl isn't doing a lot. And I would taunt if they do want to get Rocks up or Sword Stance. And they are not scarfed. And they went for straight up Iron Head, which is fine. I think I go into my Pheromone. Yeah, we go into our Pheromone to try to scare this thing off. If they are Chapel Berry, the High Jump Kick will still kill. But we do miss High Jump Kick again. Again, like last week, and we do die to the Iron Head. Great job, Pheromosa. High Jump Kick is such a good move. Damn. Gotta love it. Oh my lord. And we go into our... So the game is looking really grim right now. We lost our Pheromosa. We don't have... anything left except our defensive core and the Diggersby trying to sweep. And I went for the Will-O-Wisp here on this Yveltal. So, yeah, we do get that at least. And I go straight into my Sylveon, I believe. Here, we don't want to take the Dark Pulse into our face. Yeah. We go into a silver. Oh, I went into my Akron. Whoa. In the same place, I believe. They went for the U-turn, and it does 4 damage on us. God damn, this U-turn is so strong. 4 damage on U-turn. Oh my lord. And they go into their Excadrill here, which ain't burned because they will have the burn. I could go into my Excadrill here. Did I do that? No. I just stayed in and took the Earthquake here. We do take a lot of damage from like 80, around 80, and we went for the Stealth Rock. Oh yeah, we do need that Stealth Rock so we can go any man after rocks, if, so they are not the Sash or anything. And I go straight into my Suratina if they do want to rapid spin on us, but yeah. Suratina is such good man, oh my lord! And they did indeed go for that Rapid Spin, so we know that they are Rapid Spin, Earthquake, and Iron Head. And the fourth move is something else. And I believe we go for the Shadow Ball here. They went for the Aromatisse, trying to not be predictable with the Yveltal. And we went for the Shadow Ball. And we don't want to stay in here, because the Moonblast will still hurt, even if we are Giratina. It really does hurt on us. So yeah. Let's see. They switch out the Aromatisse here. And Kyurem coming in on us. Ooh, that's scary. That is scary. And Kyurem showing us that pressure here. We will always play Kyurem. I believe we will always play the Aromatisse. Did we? Damn, we are bold. Oh my lord. What if they stayed in? Yep, the Kyurem is in. And I go into my Sylveon to see what that this Kyurem is about. Do they do the Raka move or Dragon move or do they go to the Ice Beam? Oh, I went with the Mega Akron. And the ice beam comes off and just straight up kills us. That's a specs Kirin if I've ever seen one. And now we go into our Sylveon. Yep, Sylveon can take the specs ice beam somewhat well and kill it off with the hyper voice. So yep. Easy. And we go for the hyper voice, obviously. And the only switch for them is probably the Excadrill here. They really can't go into anything else. Maybe Aramathis, but... excuse me. Oh my lord. Excadrill comes in with the whole breaker. And we go straight into the Giratina. We are 3 against 4. Situation isn't that bad at all, and we go, what do? They probably earthquake here. Yeah, they went for the earthquake. Does the 63 damage this time. And we heal above 200, which is great because we can take 4 of those now. They are hard swapping into the evil world. I think I went for the hard swap as well. Because we can't let this man come in. No, I just went for the Shadow Ball. Okay. Our Sylveon is that damaged that we can't really take 2 Dark Pulses anymore. But it's burned, so that's good. I think... do we stay in on Giratina? Let's see. Oh... no, I went for the Sylveon. Yeah. Because if we do die to this, it's okay. Yeah, but they went for the U-turn. Which might be a mistake at this point of the game. They are preserving the evil or the switches a lot, which I don't really get. But they go into the Terrakion, which is like wow. I'm just hyper voicing whatever they do. We are hyper voicing that man, and they go for the Rock EMC themselves. Like good lord. Boom. The Rockion going in on a Sylveon. Like, Sylveon isn't taking this anything. Like, nothing is taking this. Well. But yeah, we do know the item now. It's not Choice Panic, it's not Choice Scarfed, it's not Focus Sash, it's not Sugar Berry, so Diggersby is going to have a great time. And I literally press Diggersby right away. We can't win this if I don't show them that, or like, tell them that I'm Scarfed. So I press Agility here, I believe, and they are indeed going to Excadrill, I believe, sacking it off, and we are focused still. So yeah, we get that Agility off now. Nice. Speed rose, and we do kill this Excadrill with Earthquake. So Diggersby is going in here. If they do go Evelthal, they are Sucker Punch or something, but it's better, so we don't take anything from that. They go into the Aromatis here. So we do kill, depending on their set. Like, it depends completely on set. If they are fully physical, we are not killing. We go for the return and it barely lives. Which is same because we lose our focus as here and now. But this Moonblast ain't really doing a lot to us. And yeah. And DSP is still killing everything in one hit. And we go return on again. And we get that kill, which is nice. They go into the Evelthal here, and even if they are Sucker Punch, Choice Banded, anything, like, it doesn't do anything to us. Go for the Earthquake. No, the Earthquake return. Don't go for the Earthquake, that's showing. They indeed do a lot of damage with Sucker Punch. Well, a lot. Taking the burn into account. Into the count. And they go into the Terrakion, which ain't Scarfed, so we do win this game with the Diggersby endgame sweep, even after the Hellite Sound kick miss with Feromotion, which is very, very nice. Whew. In this game, I'm glad I got the Choice Scarf bait off. Like, I went immediately Diggersby, I didn't think it at all. I was like, okay, we can't win if I don't go Diggersby now. So yeah, because we do need the Giratina for possibly endgame if the DKSP would die to Sake Punch and stuff like that. Maybe quick attack on the Terrakion, but yeah. I'm very glad we won this. DKSP went in and we got our revenge on the Shy. No freezes this time, but did get that high jump kick miss. God damn it, Theromosa. I think I missed all of them, maybe. Like, really? How can you, like, 90% accuracy and I'm missing, like, all of them? God damn. But yeah, next week we are going against Mir Pokemaster, the coach of the Kentucky Thoracats, I think. And they have a scary team, they have Mega Mewtwo X, which sucks for us. So yeah, but we will see you guys next week. Bye.